Hello and welcome to the Trauma Treatment Collective vlog. Today we're going to be talking about what is somatic work. So this may be something that you've heard, a term that you've heard out in the trauma treatment field, or maybe you've never heard of it before, and I will be have the privilege of sharing with you what somatic work is. So somatic work, I will tell you, I didn't run into somatic work until about 4 years ago. I didn't even know what somatic work was. I spent most of the beginning of my trauma treatment career, and I've been doing this for about 15 years. So the first, let's say 10 years of my trauma treatment career, really focusing in on the brain and understanding trauma from a cognitive perspective. And then when I ran into somatic work, it was kind of like all the pieces started to click in. And that's the best way I ever describe it, is like when I learned about how to include the body into my trauma treatment, it was like everything started like click, 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 click. It was like the lost piece of the puzzle that then everything came together for me. So I'm really passionate about talking about somatic work and the importance of somatic work in trauma treatment. It's not for everyone. Everyone doesn't have to do it, but I at least like to share with you a little bit about it and talk a little bit about it so that you can consider whether it's something you wanna grow your skills in and how you wanna incorporate it into your work. Or if you're just passionate about it, we can just have a conversation about it because you love it as much as I do. So let's get started. So somatic work is basically the approach that focuses, it's a couple of different approaches. There's different modalities, different ways of doing somatic work. And so there's lots of different ways. So I'll link to in the description section an association that you can kind of look at that talks about specifically somatic psychotherapy. But I'll also talk a little bit at the end about some other ways that you can do somatic work. So first of all, it's an approach that works with the body and the nervous system. So the autonomic nervous system, which is made up of two branches, the sympathetic nervous system and the parasympathetic nervous system. And then we also have the polyvagal theory that plays in there that kind of breaks the parasympathetic nervous system down into two more branches, which is the dorsal and the ventral vagal systems. But it looks at all of that and it works with all of that. So the idea is it's based on interception, that our bodies are subconsciously constantly taking in information to let us know if we're safe or not. So there's this vagus nerve, which they call sometimes the wandering nerve, that runs down from our brainstem throughout our body, and it attaches to multiple systems within our body. So it attaches to our heart, our lungs, our kidneys, our gut, all of the different things. And so that is taking in information from all of those different systems and kind of sending it back up to the brain saying, you're safe, you're not safe. It also has a lot of different nerves within the face too. And so it's picking up facial cues and kind of how our face is, the tone, it's in our ears. So it's connected throughout. And that's why I guess call it the wandering nerve. And it's constantly taking in information and saying, are you safe? Are you not safe? Are you safe? Are you not safe? And it's all happening subconsciously. It's not something that we're saying, I'm safe, okay, I'm sending this message to my heart, I'm safe. And so our bodies are doing this subconsciously. And so the idea of being able to work with that system is really helpful, because if you think about it, a lot of times our clients will say things, and you hear them say things like, I know I'm safe, rationally I know I'm safe, but I just don't feel safe. And so because maybe their systems are wired to kind of maybe pick up things that in the environment that feel like they may not be safe, but that's based on past experiences. In the present day, it's safe, but maybe past experiences, it wasn't safe. And so the body is picking up that signal that they're not safe, but in their mind, they're looking at it saying, it's not a problem. But the body is getting information and picking it up and deciphering it as, oh, this looks like, feels like, smells like this old experience that we had, so now I'm not safe. And so you really have to work with the two parts to be able to kind of align them and make sure that they are getting the same message, and that the same message is communicated to them, so that they can be able to really tell the whole being, your client, that they're safe. So they don't have these mixed messages coming in of, I'm not safe, I am safe, I'm not safe, I am safe. Because a lot of times when clients like know up here they're safe, but their body doesn't feel safe, they end up what I like to call white knuckling it through and pushing themselves to say, I'm safe, I'm safe, I'm safe. And that is exhausting. When you think about white knuckling something, you know, if you even just ball up your fist right now and think about the tension and the tightness and how much energy it takes to hold that position, that's a lot of energy it takes to get through life. And so clients come into my office and they're super exhausted, super worn out because they've been white knuckling it through because their body is telling them one thing and their brain is telling them another. And so when you bring in somatic work, you're able to work with the body and really send the message through the body that you're safe, as well as through the brain that you're safe. And so both systems, both of those different areas are working together, and the client is getting one cohesive message of we're safe or we're not safe. We're safe or we're not safe. And everything is working together. So that's a little bit about somatic work and why it's important for our trauma clients. Like I said, in the description section, I'm gonna link to the United States Association for Body Psychotherapy. There's a lot of great information on there. They have, of course, a membership that you can become involved in if you're not involved in it. I'm definitely considering it right now if I want to become involved in it, if it's something that I want to connect with, because I just think it's really important to be around like-minded professionals and to get, you know, information and resources and all the connections and networking with different things. I think they also have a conference that they put on each year where you can go and kind of continue to learn about somatic work and somatic work in reference to psychotherapy and how to intertwine those two things together if you are a psychotherapist. If you're not a psychotherapist, then there's other things. Like I said, there's body work, like craniosacral therapy is one of those. Reiki is another one of those. There's lots of different things that you can do. There's trauma-informed yoga, which is another body-based approach. So there's sensory motor psychotherapy, which is another approach. There's somatic experiencing, which is another body approach. So there's tons of different ways you can go. I didn't want to go into all the different things because I didn't want this to kind of be a review of all the different somatic ways of working with trauma. But I just wanted to kind of give you an introduction to somatic work and what it is and why it's important and why you might want to consider it. Some people will do tetch work. I'll mention that here. Some people will do tetch work where they are providing supportive tetch to their clients. But you don't have to work with the body. You don't have to tetch the body. So I don't want that to be a deterrent if people are not really into tetching their clients. Some people are very uncomfortable with that. You can still do somatic work with never touching your client. I always say there's some things that I see now in my client that I never noticed 4 years ago. All the first 10 years of my work, I didn't notice it. I didn't see it. I didn't think about it. I didn't look into it. I didn't question. I wasn't curious about it. But the body tells us a lot. And a lot of times I'll see a different things. As much as like if a client is like more leaning this way, like this side of their body feels really rigid and this side of their body feels really collapsed or really kind of loose, I'll help them notice that and help them to kind of feel into that and see what that's like for them, to see if something comes up. We'll just be curious about, hey, do you notice the different sides of your body feeling different? What's that like for you as you notice that? And that could tell us a lot. We could go in a whole different direction in their treatment. So hopefully this is helpful when you're thinking about somatic work, whether you want to consider somatic work and incorporating it into your treatment process. I am passionate about it, so I'm super biased. But if I didn't let somebody who was biased tell me about it, then I wouldn't have learned about it. So hopefully you will consider this and look into it and see if it's something that you'd like to consider for your own work. If it's something you're already doing, please comment in the description section and tell me about how much you love it and how much you're passionate about it and how, maybe how it changed your work. I'd love to hear your story as well. So if you would share this in your social media, share this with your community, your colleagues, your friends, your family, whoever you think might be interested in learning about somatic work, just let people know that the Trauma Treatment Collective is out there. I definitely need your help, so feel free to share, screenshot, post, send, whatever you want to do with this information. I'd love for you to put it out there and continue to help me to grow our community so that we can support as many trauma treatment professionals as possible. Have a great rest of your day. Take care, and I will talk to you soon. Bye-bye.